I hope you are having a great start to 2020, and I hope you had an amazing holiday season. Alex and I went to Vancouver and spent the holidays with my mom, and we had a really nice visit. It was also my best friend Ashley's wedding, and that was so beautiful. She was a gorgeous bride. And if you're following me on Instagram, you probably saw a ton of photos and videos that I shared from that. If you're not yet following me, you can find me at MelissaAlexandria01. Okay, so last year I shared a word of the year video, and I still can't believe a whole year has already gone by since then because it kind of feels like just the other day that I filmed that. But I thought long and hard on what I would choose as my word of the year for 2020. And nothing was really jumping out at me as a theme for this year or something that I really wanted to keep me on track or just to inspire me. But I kept coming back to these two words that have really been a theme for me for the past several months. And I just feel like going into this new year, it's going to be really helpful for me to keep those words at the forefront of my mind. So I thought I would share them with you and have a little chat about what they mean to me. Quick side note, if you haven't heard of the word of the year, it's basically where you choose one word, or in my case, two words, that remind you of your focus throughout that year. So it can be used in place of a New Year's resolution. You can write the word on a little card and keep it in your wallet or on your nightstand or by your bathroom mirror, so that when you see the word, you're reminded to focus on that particular thing. For example, if you really want to make this year all about health and fitness, and you have a specific fitness goal, your word could be discipline. And maybe just seeing that word makes you want to go to the gym or puts a mental picture into your head of you being a more disciplined version of yourself when it comes to food choices and working out. So that word is just there for you as your reminder. It just simplifies everything because you don't have to memorize the 30,000 goals that you've set for yourself that are all probably going to be forgotten within the first 2 weeks of the new year anyway. So one powerful word is just so much more effective and simple. So my two words are know yourself. Let me explain what that means to me. The better I understand myself, how my mind works, what really motivates me, what I need to do in order to feel good most of the time, how much sleep I need, what type of friend I want to be, how I need to organize my day in order to be the most effective I can be with my time, the more honest I can be with myself and aware of who and how I really am, the better choices that I can make. This also includes the somewhat uncomfortable work of being willing to take an honest look at my weaknesses and shortcomings, and where I tend to get stuck in life and where I procrastinate. So even though it's not fun to look at those things about ourselves, I really find it empowering because I'd rather be informed than keep my head in the sand and pretend to not see those parts of myself. When I could actually just admit it to myself, then I don't feel like I need to compete with people who have those qualities as their strengths. Instead, I can organize my life in a way to minimize any setbacks caused by those weaknesses and spend more time on the things that I'm good at and the things that I enjoy doing. For example, if you've been struggling with paperwork and you just feel like it's the bane of your existence and you're not good at it, then you can pay someone to help you out once a month for a couple of hours. If you weren't even willing to admit that you're struggling in that area and that no matter how much you try to get better at it, it's just not happening, then you wouldn't take the step of seeking help. There is just so much noise in this world, and it's so easy to watch what other people are doing and think that, hey, if that's working for her, then I should be doing that too, and I'll get the same great results. And it just leads me down the rabbit hole of trying a million different things and trying to make myself someone that I'm just not. When you really know yourself and the conditions that you work best in, you can shape your environment to suit that. For example, I watch Alex work on the computer at night, and he can stay up super late, work for hours while having the TV on, or maybe music and texting at the same time, things that would be so distracting to me. And if I tried to do that, I would get nothing done. But by working with my natural innate behaviors and strengths, I know that waking up super early and working in silence allows me to be so much more productive because that's just who I am. Then you are running your own race, and you can cultivate habits and techniques that really work for your life. I can go on and on because I really believe that this whole idea of knowing yourself and just understanding what really works best for you in all areas of your life makes things run so much more smoothly. This applies to looking at super organized and detailed list creators. You might feel like you have to do that in order to plan your day effectively, but there are a lot of different ways to be productive. For example, if 5-page to-do lists just stress you out, then don't use them. Do what does work for you and what inspires you to take action. In this social media world where we can see exactly what other people are eating and at what time, you might think, oh, if I want the same results as them, I have to do exactly what they did. But you know what feels best for you, and I think that the more that you can truly know yourself, the more pleasant life becomes. All right, thanks for watching, guys. I'd love to know what is your word of the year for 2020. Feel free to leave that in the comment section down below. And if you're not yet subscribed to my channel, click that subscribe button to become a part of my YouTube family. See you guys next time. Bye.